Hi there, Cheryl B. Englehart here. Welcome back to Key Conversations, the podcast where we talk about all the things to inspire you to have an awesome music career.
I am going to share a little bit of information about how the Billboard charts work, because I have been doing some serious research and learning so much and having tons of conversations, and the rules have changed literally last week that kind of threw me for a loop, and I'm a little bummed about it because I was playing one game. Now I gotta pivot a little bit. Hey, Harold. So here's how the Billboard charts work in America. There are a certain number of websites like Amazon, iTunes, Bandcamp that report directly to SoundScan. SoundScan keeps track of sales. There's also indie hit music. They can report sales for you if you make sales at music venues, if you sell through other sites. So basically, you make some sales, the sales go to SoundScan. SoundScan collects all the data, sends it to Billboard. They create the charts, right? So in the past, Billboard charts were designed to count the sales of songs, of albums, and they would make the chart. And so I have some friends that have been on the charts, and they said that they think they had about 300 to 500 sales. Great. So I was able to finally look up the data and see that 2 weeks ago, the guys that were number one on the Billboard chart in New Age, which is the category that I'm in right now. Hey, everybody. I didn't mean to do that. How do I come back? Come back. There we go. Patrick. So this is what I'm learning. I'm telling about the Billboard things that I'm learning. So a couple weeks ago, the guys that were number one on the Billboard chart in the New Age category sold 208, I think it was, records. Last week, Enya was number one. She sold 208. Maybe the other guys were 185. We're talking about a couple hundred record sales. Some rules changed last year in other genres where it's no longer record sales, it's now record consumption. And consumption now includes streaming on Spotify, Napster, Google Music, Amazon, YouTube. So for an artist that might have millions and millions of streams, for every 1,500 streams, that equals one album sale. So that was not applicable to the New Age category until last week. Last week, they changed it. So instead of getting sales, it's now about consumption. So my game was, let's get 500 pre-orders, 500 sales for that first week and hit the Billboard chart. And guess what? Last week, if I had released my record last week, I would have been number one on the Billboard chart because I beat out that 208. But what I found out this year is that the number to beat is actually 4,000. Womp womp. And I don't have a big streaming file of all the things as an indie artist that I do. And one of the things I've never focused on is Spotify. It's just not been a priority, and I don't care. People are like, you don't have a lot of Spotify followers, but you have all this huge email list, or you have this. And I'm like, I don't care. That's what I focus on gross. So 2008 sales, physical sales, not of the physical CD, Patrick, but of digital CD or physical CD. But it's a sale. And then there's, I think it's song for every 100 song downloads, 10 count as a sale or something. You divide it by 10 for individual songs. So now it's sale. So for example, I have the numbers from Enya. So she hit 1,700 song sales. So that turns into whatever the numbers, 300 and something albums. But she had 6.3 million streams on Spotify. And that turns into like 700 albums or something. And she had 220 sales. So my goal 2 weeks ago would have been, let's just get past 220. But now it's, let's get past 4,000. And to do that without a streaming fan base is opening up some new questions for me. So this is all new information I just got today. I did not know that the rules changed for New Age last week. If I knew that this was happening, I probably would have released my CD 2 weeks ago, which I was debating. And I am a little sad, a little bummed, and I've been making a big poo-poo about being really close to hitting the Billboard charts, and I've just got to pivot a little bit. So I don't think my game is to grow my Spotify in the next 4 weeks. I think I'm going to play the game of see how many, if I can get a couple thousand pre-sales. Maybe we can play with Spotify. I don't know. I might need to get some help because I'm not a Spotify pro. So that's the info. That's how the Billboard charts work in America. I don't know if all the charts are now consumption based. I don't know if they were slowly going from the main charts all the way down to the smaller categories, including New Age. So depending on your genre, you'd have to look into your genre. But I just wanted to share what is up with my game. And you all know that my end game is a Grammy, right? It has been since for like 2 decades. But I thought that this Billboard would be a really good milestone, a really good engagement thing. And I'm still going to be playing it with a vengeance. So watch out.